Dear students and my teacher friends, Namaskar. I welcome you to the presentation lecture on single gene crosses, also known as monofactorial crosses. So today in this lecture, we are discussing about single gene crosses or the monofactorial crosses. So let's begin. So first of all, see, this is the title on the top, single gene crosses, okay, or in the bracket it is written monofactorial crosses. So this is the title of our lecture. Now see the definition, okay, what is single gene crosses. So see, here it is written, the monofactorial crosses is a mating in which only a single gene is analyzed or monitored in this cross. So here in monofactorial crosses, the heredity of a single gene we are studying. Now what is the meaning of this thing, heredity, the study of heredity of single gene, how we are going to study it? For this, I am giving you one example. Let's say a particular type of animal is there, and we are studying the coat color of this animal. Okay. Now, in this animal, there are two type of coat color. There are two type of varieties, or maybe you can think that it's up to you that the third variety is possible or not. For example, one coat color is the black color and the other coat color is the white color. So now for the, let's say the gene which is responsible for black color, we we are using the letter capital B, okay, and for the white color, let's say the white color is the recessive one, so we are using the small b. So now there will be a homozygous dominant variety, capital B, capital B is possible, recessive possible, small b, heterozygous possible, and what will be the color of the offspring, okay, the children or the first progeny that is produced. So what will be their body color, what will be the coat color, that is the question. So black color will be there, or the white color will be there, or the body color is black, or in between white spots are there, or another blending is there, means some different kind of color is produced, brown color is produced. So all this thing we are studying for one single gene. So one single gene, the how the allelic combination okay, what are the alleles that are present in the gamete, that we are going to study, how the fertilization take place, what is the allelic combination of zygote, and what is the phenotype of the offspring. So this is how one particular gene is studied, okay. And see, this cross over here, it is written, this cross demonstrate Mendel's principle of segregation. We have already studied Mendel's law of segregation, and according to law of segregation, when the gametes are formed, that time the chromosome they separate, and the gamete receive only one set of chromosome. That means the half number of chromosome are present in a particular gamete, okay, and instead of two copies, generally in the diploid organism, all the body cell, they are having the two set of chromosome, and that's why the organism or the individual are known as the diploid. But in case of gamete, there is only one set of chromosome is present and only one particular allele is present. So instead of two copy of gene, only one copy of gene, that means one allele is present in the gamete, okay. So we have studied this in the Mendel's principle of segregation, that in the gamete only one allele is present, okay. Now see, there are six type of crosses that can be performed to uncover various genetic relationship. So for there are six type of monofactorial crosses. Okay, and these crosses are referred as, they are sometimes known as monohybrid crosses. Okay, so here the for this single gene or the monofactorial crosses, the example we are going to study is the pelage color in the guinea pig. Now what is the meaning of pelage? So over here it is written, see, pelage. Okay, and pelage, definition of pelage, so the hairy covering of mammals. Okay, hairy covering of mammal is known as pelage. So here what we are studying the heredity for the pelage color in guinea pig. Okay, and pair of allele governing the pelage color in the guinea pig. So for this simplicity, we are studying the heredity of hair color in the guinea pig. Okay, now if dominant B allele is present, okay, so it will produce a black color, and if recessive alleles are present, small b, so it will produce the white color in the guinea pig. Okay, and there are six types of mating possible. There are six type of mating possible among the three genotype. Okay, so in the guinea pig we will find three type of genotype, and six possible type of matings are six type of matings are possible between these three genotype. So now we are looking at which are the three genotype and which are the six possible matings. Okay, then whenever we start our cross, okay, whenever in the genetics from the individual or the animal or the organism, whenever we start our experiment, those individual or the organism are known as the parent, okay, or the parental generation or the P generation. And P generation crosses, P cross take place, okay, and the first generation. So first generation is known as the first filial generation, F1 generation, and it is symbolized by F1. All this thing we are knowing it. Okay, now I am showing you the pelage color, okay, in the guinea pig. See over here, on top of me you can see this guinea pig. Okay, and this guinea pig, this is the pelage. Okay, this is called the pelage, and we can see the pelage is black in color. Okay, now this guinea pig, okay, this guinea pig, the pelage white in color. Okay, now this is the, this two are involved in mating. Okay, the sexual intercourse they are performing, and due to the mating they are producing the offspring. Okay, so this children, we can say these are the progeny, first filial generation. This is just example I am giving you. Okay, in reality what is the coat color and all this thing we are discussing. Okay, what is the pelage color over here we are discussing. Now the first example we are discussing, okay, see, we are starting with the parent. Okay, let's say this guinea pig is the female guinea pig, and this one is the male guinea pig. Okay, both male and female guinea pig are homozygous. and they are having dominant allele. So here capital B, here capital B, capital B, and over here also capital B, capital B. So now here you can see, see the female, okay, female is homozygous, so the female is having two dominant allele, and male guinea pig is also homozygous, and male guinea pig is having two dominant allele as well. Okay, so now this female is going to produce the ovum, and in the ovum only one allele is present, okay, for pelage color. Similarly, over here in the sperm only one copy of gene, that means one allele is present, that is capital B in all the sperm. So all the sperms are having capital B allele, and all the ovums are having small capital B allele. Okay, so now this sperm is going to fertilize this ovum. So now the zygote is going to form, and in the zygote the allelic combination is capital B, capital B. So whatever the number of F1 generation, okay, whatever the number of offspring, whatever the number of children, let's say 10 or 8 or 7, so all the offspring of first generation individual, all the F1 guinea pigs are black in color, they are having black pelage. Okay, now the second example, now second monofactorial cross. See, now here in this case we are starting with the parent, and here let's say this is female, okay, guinea pig, and this one is a male guinea pig. Okay, so here female is homozygous black, okay, and female is having capital B, capital B allele for the pelage color, which is black, and here the male is heterozygous, so one capital B and one small B allele. Now when the gametes are formed, so in the ovum always one copy of gene, one allele capital B is present, so the ovum of the guinea pig are always having capital B allele. And here in this sperm, because the male guinea pig was heterozygous, that's why this male is producing two type of sperm. Okay, in half the sperm capital B allele is present, and the remaining half sperm are having small B allele. So now it depends on which type of sperm is fertilizing this ovum. Let's say this ovum is fertilized by this sperm, so in the zygote there will be capital B, capital B allele. Okay, or it is possible that the recessive allele, the sperm which is having recessive allele, and this sperm is fertilizing the ovum, so in that case in the zygote the allelic combination will be capital B, small b. And here the F1 generation guinea pigs are always black, and either they are homozygous or they are heterozygous, but the phenotype is black pelage. The reason, because capital, in any case capital B is present, and capital B, we know capital B is the dominant allele, that's why, and it is the expressive one. Okay, and so here we can say the 50% progeny is homozygous, okay, and 50% progeny is heterozygous, but phenotype all black. Okay, so this is how we are interpreting this second monofactorial cross. Okay, see, now there are four more monofactorial cross, okay, And once we discuss all this crosses, then we need to make a table, okay? And this table over here, you can see mating, okay? Mating, then the expected F1 ratio, genotype, okay? Phenotype. Now, for the genotype, earlier in the old genetic book, you will find they were writing the fraction, but nowadays we are writing the numbers for the genotypes, okay? So the new this is the old table, okay? This complete table is there, and the new table also I'm going to show you. See this complete lecture, okay, on monofactorial cross. We have discussed two monofactorial crosses, two example, okay? Then four monofactorial crosses are still remaining, and I am continuing my discussion in this lecture. And this is the, this you can say this is the glimpse of my lecture, okay? And if you want to watch this complete lecture, you can simply log in to my app. You can watch this lecture, and in this lecture we are going to discuss the tables also, okay? Mating type, the genotype, phenotype, the ratios, and the old table and the new table, all this thing, the complete lecture I have already uploaded on my app. So you can, I am inviting you to watch this full lecture on my app. My name is Manish Koshi sir. I am from Ahmedabad, India. Bye bye. Namaste.